everyone here today. I hope you're just as excited as I am. Just being up here with all this innovation and technology, it just inspires me every day. I hope it's the same for each and every one of you. Well, my name is Timothy Min, and I'm actually a master's student here in the music technology program. Furthermore, I have the lovely privilege of being your MC tonight. So before we go any further, please join me in welcoming Hub, Steve McLaughlin, Provost and Executive Vice President.
Here to the 2022 Guthman Musical Instrument Competition at Georgia Tech. Isn't it absolutely awesome to be back in person? What began as a piano contest 22 years ago has since become one of the world's premier events for musical technologists and creators. This year, we welcome 26 semifinalists from 16 countries, and our 10 finalists you're about to meet tonight represent Austria, Canada, France, Hungary, Spain, the UK, United States, and Venezuela. It's absolutely no exaggeration to say that the Guthman competition is a one-of-a-kind experience. It's a destination event that attracts skilled contestants, academics, and industry leaders from across the globe. It's part concert, part contest, part conference, and part museum exhibit. Where else do students and professionals, musicians and inventors, and technologists and professors all get together? For some, it's a rare opportunity to reveal their creations on an international stage. For others, it's a glimpse into the future of music creation and performance, as well as a singular display of human creativity and ingenuity. It's also a ton of fun. There's a long and cherished tradition of music here at Georgia Tech. Students have been playing and performing here since 1906, and our 12 ensembles in the School of Music represent every single major on campus. But here at Tech, we don't just compose and play music, we also tinker with it, and we redefine it and invent new ways to create and experience it. Tonight's performances will combine traditional musicianship with advanced technology and playful experimentation to transform common perceptions of what music is and how it's made. Surely, few events are so uniquely Georgia Tech. Faculty from our School of Music, students in our Music Technology program, and local Atlanta musicians will all be performing with the finalists tonight. They've only just met, and part of the fun will be watching how they improvise together. I can't wait to hear how the show they brought together for us tonight. On behalf of the Institute, I want to thank our esteemed judges for lending us their expertise and for all the contestants for their phenomenal inventions. Most of all, my gratitude goes out to Jason Freeman. You're going to meet the awesome Jason Freeman in a little bit. Gil Weinberg from the Center of Music Technology. And Ellen Bassett, our new dean from the College of Design. And of course, the Guthman family, who's enduring a vision and generosity to make tonight such a signature event. And now, it's time to get started, Tim.
All right. Thank you so much, Steve. And next up, would you welcome Jordan Rose, co-director of Atlanta Science Festival.
For those of you who don't know, Paola is a virtuoso jazz band
with Victor Wooten, one of the most amazing bassists you've ever heard, and Vic's brother, who's called Future Man, who comes out on stage with this janky-looking box with a neck sticking out of it, with buttons and pads and controllers and tabs, and it's what he calls the Synth-Ax Drumitar. And that was my first introduction to music technology. And I hope that what you hear tonight from these amazing finalists will be just as inspiring as that was to me. I can't wait to hear from these amazing competitors. You all have in your hands, I hope, a pink booklet of science-y fun. Is that not right? Yeah? Okay, if you can hold it up, we're gonna take a selfie. It'll work with the lights. We're gonna take a selfie. Okay, everybody hold up your booklet, and on the count of three, say science. One, two, three.
Science!
Excellent. Thank you. Enjoy tonight.
Thank you so much, Jordan. So, let's talk a little bit about Guthman. What is it, right? So, instrument makers from all around the world sent in submissions to this competition, and of all those numerous submissions, 26 semifinalists were chosen by a panel of Georgia Tech faculty. And of those 26, today we have 9 finalists who were selected to come here to compete by the faculty panel, but also by popular vote from the public, from viewers like you. Thank you. So yesterday, each finalist gave a presentation and demo to our judges, and you'll get to meet the judges in just a little bit. So earlier today, we matched up each of the finalists with an Atlanta-based virtuosic musician. So once again, this is the first time they ever met each other, and they're gonna perform something for you, what they made today. Isn't that crazy? So once again, they'll come on stage together to show you how each of these instruments work and what makes them so awesome and innovative. And at the end of the night, the audience will vote on their favorite instrument, and finally, we'll announce the winners of the competition. So, will you join me in welcoming our first judge of the night, Paula Antonelli? Paula Antonelli is a senior curator and director of research and development at the Museum of Modern Art in New York, where she focuses on architecture and design. Paula will tell us more about our first finalist, Xiao Xiao, one of the inventors of T-Voks, who will be performing her instrument alongside Zach Shaw, a pianist in Georgia Tech's jazz program, as well as a biomedical engineering major.
Thank you, Timothy. So, good evening, everyone. I'm so happy to be here in Atlanta. I'm so happy to be here with you. It's been quite an amazing couple of days, and I'm so proud to be introducing to you Xiao Xiao, who together with a team composed of Christophe D'Alessandro and Grégoire Locqueville and Boris Duval invented this amazing, amazing instrument that you'll get to hear shortly. The theremin is already a haunting, magical, incredible instrument to begin with, but imagine if the synthetic sound that you hear at night from the theremin became a voice, a human voice that can sing lyrics or read poetry. Can you imagine what it would mean if you could modulate in the space the way a theremin player only can? If you could modulate this voice and create haunting sounds and phrases and lyrics. I know that I was enraptured listening to her. So I would like to invite to the stage Xiao Xiao. And Timothy already announced your partner for the night. So take it away.
Thank you.
tu me commences et moi qui ne parle tout bas, je vois la mer et en route. Il me dit des mots d'amour, des mots de tous les jours, et ça fait quelque chose. Il est entré dans mon cœur, une part de bonheur.
So Gerhard will tell us more about our next finalist, Cicada. Spencer from startup company Physical Synthesis will be joined on stage by Sam Cape, an Atlanta-based composer and sound designer, and also GT alumni.
I have the honor to be here. I'm so grateful that Georgia Tech brought me. Incredible event possible. It is so important that this happens. Thank you so much. And I have the honor to introduce you to Cicada by Physical Synthesis. It is a bridge building instrument. When I say bridge building, I mean the bridge between the electronic music and the physical world. So in a very simplified manner, you can say this is a combination of a loudspeaker and a microphone. What happens is that at the junction of both, there's a person, a performer, intervening in intricate and nonlinear ways. So it becomes a haptic interaction that brings physicality and real life to electronic music. I find this very exciting. I find it's work on an important gap that needs addressing. And we found the Cicada a particularly mature and well-engineered, beautiful instrument. It's ready for prime time. Enjoy.
You're at the Guthman competition. So next, will you join me in welcoming up our third judge, Rick Bayard.
Thank you.
next instrument that you will hear tonight is called the air glow. The air glow combines two of my favorite things, which is air guitar, anybody that has ever watched my YouTube channel, and lightsabers. It's a multi-dimensional controller, and it has a colored fingerboard that you'll see on it. It's interesting. I talked to Chad, who developed it, and he said that the colors are associated with tonic, predominant, and dominant chords. And it's really interesting the way that he conceived of that. Please welcome Eric.
Next up, you will experience The Globe by Chantal Coe. So Chantal has a background as a violinist, as a dancer, and as a composer. And when she starts making a new composition, the first thing she does is make a new instrument. So she's already made a bunch. However, with The Globe, it's different. The Globe is made to be open. It's a instrument that is a smart combination of sensors and lights in a transparent shell. And it really is open to what the performer will do with it on a given night. So tonight, our performer is going to be a student here from the Music Tech program. It's Mia Jeffries. Welcome.
Stefan Liqueri comes from Venezuela, and he's a polyglot and restless, curious, and learner of music that has studied all over the world with some of the best virtuosos. Especially he studied guitar and saxophone. But he's not only a musician, he's also a designer, a lutist. He makes instruments, and the one that you see tonight is not his first one, but definitely is the one that he's put all of his heart and soul into. It's a guitar, and at the same time, it's a synthesizer. It's an instrument that is as beautiful as it is powerful, and that he's very, very proud of. And tonight, he's going to be joined here on stage by John Kaysen, who is a virtuoso guitarist and a major of music technology at Georgia Tech. Stefan, John.
Franz Eck aus Wien, from Vienna, wanted to create an instrument that helps us get past our musical biases. So, instead of building on the musical concepts that are so deeply ingrained in our brains and as musicians in our hands, he made Aristide. And with Aristide we can explore with our hands pitch sets that are created by the growth patterns of plants. Tonight, Aristide will be played by Franz, and we will have him joined by Jeremy Mother, a percussionist and electronic musician from the area. Thank you.
Thank you.
It's beautiful. Thank you so much. Well, I had promised myself tonight that I would not read and that I would not wear my glasses, but I will, just for a moment, to introduce my compatriot, Giacomo Lepri. Actually, my co-jurors and I fought over who would introduce him, and then I said, you know what, I'm Italian, so I introduce him. And I am super happy to introduce him to you tonight, but I have to read a little bit of the explanation of his in Italian, and it's an instrument based on a magnetic pendulum whose trajectories are altered by magnets placed underneath the device. This creates unstable patterns. You know what, I mean, that becomes too much, but just so you understand, there are pendulums, magnets underneath, you move the magnets with your hands, and by moving the magnets, you create amazing music. Let's just put it that way. But it's not only that, it's just the whole installation is almost like a little Calder theater, and it's made using inspiration from Leonardo da Vinci's machine, so it's this whole crescendo of Italianity and fabulous electronic music, so I think you will appreciate it. And Giacomo tonight is joined on stage by Brad Ritchie, who is a cellist with the Atlanta Chambers Atlanta Chamber is something. Let's welcome here tonight, Brad and Giacomo.
Thank you. Next, we have hypercubes. By connecting modules together, you can generate, modify, and control electronic sounds without the need of cables or computers. I asked Mateo, how do you know if the cubes are connected properly? He said, because they use magnets, and if they're not connected properly, they repel each other. Brilliant. Please welcome hypercubes.
Hello, hello. Oh, I can hear myself now. How's everybody doing today? Yeah. It is so beautiful to see all of you out here. So, let's do this. Echo, echo, echo. That sounds cool, right? Let's try it. If they're telling you to slow down, run, don't walk. Let's try one more time. You got the cadence now. If they're telling you to slow down, run, don't walk. Okay. Just one more time for the people in the back. If they're telling you to slow down, run, don't walk. Yes, that's it. All right. 'Cause there are no rules. Do what you do. Run, don't walk.
Thank you. guys so much.
Okay, thank you so much, Hypercubes. I actually think one of the most fascinating things about Hypercubes is that if you look at a Eurorack or just any board in general, there's so many cables everywhere that you're like, I went from here, I know I went here, now I'm over here, and I'm over here. And you say that like 80 more times, you know? So this one, it's almost like Legos where you just, and that's it. Oh, so innovative. So before we move on to the voting, we actually got confirmation that the globe has been fixed once more and is able to perform. So let's welcome Globe to the stage once more. Wow, thank you so much, Club. So now we'll be moving into the People's Choice Award. But before that, I just have a small statement, I guess. I think the beauty within the Guthman competition is that it's so much more than a concert. For me, I see that it's inspiration. It gives us new ideas about innovation and how to go about it from there. And so we hope that not only is it a fantastic concert and something to witness in person, but also something that will continue to inspire you as you leave this place today. So let's move on to the People's Choice Award. There it is. So as you know, the judges are awarding the cash prizes, but an additional award comes from you. This is the People's Choice Award, and that includes you, everyone online. So to vote, simply navigate to tinyurl.com/Guthman22. Once again, that is tinyurl.com/Guthman22. Thanks for voting. And so while you're voting right now, let me introduce some people onto the stage. First, I'd like to welcome all the finalists and these people to help present the awards. The judges, Rick Beato, Paola Antonelli, and Garrett Bells. Next, we would like to invite Gil Weinberg, director of the Georgia Tech Center for Music Technology, Jason Freeman, chair of the Georgia Tech School of Music, Charlie Rogers and Maggie Rogers, representing the Guthman family, Aaron Shackford, director of Georgia Tech Arts, Ellen Bassett, dean of College of Design, Chawi Abdallah, executive vice president for research, and finally, Angel Cabrera, president of Georgia Tech.
Thank you so much. Wasn't this exciting? Wow, I am inspired. Well, so here's a word for all the boys and girls in the audience today. And I hope you're taking full advantage of this amazing Atlanta Science Festival. So much cool stuff happening. And I was thinking the whole time is think about all these amazing inventors when they had the conversation with their parents and said, Mom and Dad, I want to do music, which that already creates an interesting family conversation. And they say, okay, what instrument are you going to play? I'm going to invent one. So just think about what it takes to be an inventor and how cool it is, but how difficult it is when you have an idea and everybody's telling you you have lost your mind. Well, guess what? The telephone, which now we all carry in our phones, about 150 years ago, there was a guy by the name of Alexander Graham Bell who said, I can actually help you communicate over distance and turn your voice into a wire. People thought he had lost their mind. In the 1920s, then some musicians started putting telephones inside of their violins and their guitars. People thought, why would you do that? And then in the 30s, you started some have some jazz musicians and country musicians started playing a weird, very strange instrument, which is an electric guitar, which now opened up the whole era of rock and roll. And then in the 70s, there were some innovators in New York City who started playing with turntables and mixing music in very funny ways. People thought they had lost their mind. Now we have hip hop. So think about it, in a few years, there's gonna be a whole new way of doing music based on some of the crazy instruments that you saw today. And you will be able to say, I was there when it all happened. And so my word to you, yes, you were there. So just my word to you is science, engineering can be so incredibly cool. Even if you think, no, I'm into music. I don't do math, well, guess what? All these inventors who are amazing musicians, they had to understand physics and how sound waves work. And they have to understand electrical engineering, and they have to understand how to code, and they have to understand science and technology to find new ways of doing beautiful things. So yes, to all the boys and girls in the room, I hope many of you will end up very soon at Georgia Tech becoming the next geniuses and inventors like the ones we just saw. I am so inspired. Thank you all so very much.
And now we have some final remarks from the judges.
I'm channeling also my two colleagues here, Gerhard and Rick, to tell you that it's been really hard. You know, we've been deliberating for a long time and eviscerating all the qualities of every single entry and tried to understand whether the music came first or the instrument came first and where it was all going to go. But to make a long story short, it was an amazing experience as judges also. And I would just like to say, you know, one person will win, a second person will be in second place, and then the third and the fourth, and so on and so forth. But in truth, there's so much potential just in this competition and in this school. And at this time when there's so much going on in the world that is so frightening and touching each one of us, no matter how far we are from the heart of the war and the invasion that's going on right now, creativity helps us all lift our spirits, lift our souls, and maybe even find a way to go forward. So I would like to really thank these wonderful designers on behalf of the whole jury.
Now we'll announce the winners, and I have the privilege of asking Charlie Rogers to announce them for us.
I don't know about privilege, but I'll do what I can here. All right, so first we're going to announce the People's Choice Award, what everyone just voted on. And that winner is the Glitzotar. Congratulations. All right, now for our third place winner. Sorry. Oh no, the judge's special award first, right? The judge's special award for the most mature instrument goes to the cicada. All right, now for our third place award. This goes to the ciondolo. And our second place award goes to T-Voks. First place award. This goes to the glissitar.
Yes, congratulations to everyone and to all the finalists. And on behalf of Georgia Tech, thank you and good night.